All right. Ah, finally, I have reached La-Mulana. Just got off work. That's pretty good timing then, I guess. I'm doing pretty good. Or well, I should say. Been working on a writing assignment this weekend, which I just submitted probably about 20 minutes ago or something. After doing my umpteenth proofreading. Probably missed something, but whatever. It didn't strike me as a thoroughly challenging assignment, but I suppose I'll have to wait and see what the marking standards are like in this class, since this is one of my first... it is my first written submission. All the other measures we've had are quizzes and the like. So, I'll have to see how the markers mark things, and then I guess I'll figure things out from there. But, yeah, pretty easy assignment. It's, summarize a research article. So, yeah, it's kind of nice. Got that finished, and now get to relax with a little La-Mulana. It's actually pretty cool. I was in Ultra J-Man stream last night. He started kicking off some of his online practice for the original game. And I think he's doing some more tonight as well. So, that's pretty cool. Got to hang out, ask some questions about the original, and check out some of the stuff in the speedrun that's a little bit newer, or, you know, kind of cool, interesting differences between the games. It's actually really funny how similar the routes are in a lot of ways, and different in some that are subtle. Which will also be helpful, as if the original wins the bidding war, then I'll be on the couch, and if I have some valuable things to remark about the original game and its run, then that might be helpful for J-Man. Was my writing assignment about how Miku is the greatest thing to be created? I don't think so, as I'm not sure who or what it is that you're precisely referring to, which I get the feeling is going to put me on the receiving end of some flack after making that statement. But no, my writing assignment was on a classic research study done in 1968 by Letanier, I believe is how you pronounce his name, and Darley, on the subject of diffusion of responsibility and bystander intervention, or lack thereof. Dealt with a murder case surrounding a Kitty Genovese. I also think that's how you pronounce her name. But it's kind of classic psychology stuff. I'm pretty familiar with the study already, but I just had to write a summary of the study, its methods, participants, blah, 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 all that kind of stuff. So that was pretty cool. It's a good article. Interesting read. Howdy, M1. And Digit. Yo, yo. Yeah, I don't know who Miku is, Matt. I'm sorry. Practicing Hell Temple. Yeah, I saw that run that you posted on there, Tidjud. Pretty freaking sweet, if you ask me. It was very nice. Very nice indeed. Where am I going? That's right. This is the first time that I've been here. I need to do this puzzle. As if the second time I come here, I also don't interact with that puzzle. Yeah, I know what you mean, M1. It was actually really funny. J-Man commented on something that I've had feelings myself as well, where it's like, I want to play the original. I want to, you know, work out, okay, what are the differences? What's kind of going on? What's, all that sort of stuff. But I've kind of held off because I don't want to necessarily have any kind of interference between the two if I do wind up running. So I've kind of held off, and J-Man was talking about how he wanted to finish a hard mode. He still has to finish a hard mode playthrough on the remake. And he was saying, yeah, I've wanted to get back to it, but you know, he doesn't want to screw with how you know, platforming and all those kinds of things feel for the original. So that was something I found pretty funny, that both of us are sort of in similar positions in that regard. Double bat kill hype! Cool. Bats behaving themselves. A little bit. I think it was the last run I did. The bottom bat flew straight into the pyramid. Wasn't a thing I could do about it. I feel like I want to say that's a rare pattern, since I don't encounter it that often, but you know, maybe it's a particularly average pattern and I just have gotten lucky or something. I'm short on money. It's just 2 coins, but yeah, I like that a little bit better. Oh, really? Get up there. before I was coming up to the door and then jumping and trying to get everything in. But I find if I jump much higher and I kind of put myself into the little nub here with the ladder, I get all of the knives in that I want, or that I need to destroy the barrier. And since I'm still jumping forward, I don't have to stop attacking while I'm on the ground to move. It's like completely irrelevant, minute time save. But it makes me happy, so. But we got there on the coins. If I remember correctly, one of those little insect dudes dropped some. Yeah. How's everybody else doing tonight? I know you said you just got off work, man. I imagine that's a good thing. Rapscallion. Hey, Drack at the Bound. Thanks very much. That ghost is not in the right position. Sounds like you're very competitive about your relaxation, M1. Beating everybody else. Actually less than I was expecting there, but that's all right. Yeah, 39 wasn't super quick, but that's all right. Looks like I wasn't just low on coin drops, I'm also low on soul stones. Hello? I must have pressed the item use button and tried to scan the nothing. And I don't mean the never-ending story kind of nothing, I mean like the actual, there's nothing in the background there. An absence of things to scan. Yeah, miswarping can cost you a lot of time. And also, I'm not gonna say, you know, not warping super quickly will cost you a lot of time, but you can gain a fair amount of time by being like, you know, okay, warp directly to wherever. I'll be honest, I barely even really think about it anymore. Like, that one right there, I've just gotten so used to this pattern of this kind of warping at this point in the run that, hey! It that where I warp and when becomes a little bit more second nature. There were a few that were still kind of bothering me a little bit, like the one after I kill Palenque. I wouldn't warp immediately to the Temple of the Sun, but I seem to have incorporated it fairly well. I think that's, like, the second reference I've made to the Neverending Story in, like, the last week or two? I haven't seen that movie recently. The other one that I made was, what was it? While I was working on my paper, I had... Fiesel's stream open in the background. He was playing Dragon Warrior, and he was trying to get probably like Erdrick's sword or something like that, and dying a lot because the game was kind of screwing him over. I remember typing in a chat that it was sort of like the scene with the Sphinxes and the knight, where it's all like, he's gonna make it! He's gonna make it! And then he gets struck down by, like, these laser eye bolts, and you're like, oh. He didn't make it. But. Cool movie. Like, a few years back, I had a thought about the entire film being an allegory for depression. Of course, at the time I was going through some of my own stuff, so who knows if that was just projecting or a very good observation. Who's to say? I think I've got it this time. That was pretty quick. Ah, yes. Pushing that block. Oh, wow. I did not think I was going to make that. I'm glad I didn't change the buttons I was holding. You're probably right, M1. After all, so many of the kinds of experiences that people have in life are similar in many ways. Wow, what do you mean this rock song is about a guy who got dumped by his girlfriend? Who knew? Went the wrong way with my item switch. Wow, my health is looking excellent right now. Soul stones are very good. This has been an eminently decent opener. Yeah, you and me both, man. I would also like to witness that. You know, as I'm doing it. Not, you know, somebody else. Speaking of wrong warping. Thought I was already going here. That was actually something that was crossing my mind the other day as well. Because I know after SGDQ, I want to, and I have said, to that effect, that I want to pick up other games a little bit more seriously and or different categories in this game. It's a pretty good key fairy. But on the other hand, I also really... I don't know. I'm kind of feeling keen to hit like a sub 145 target time. Which I think at this point is definitely possible if I get the right kind of luck and stuff like that. I took a look at my sum of bests the other day, and it's like a 142.51 or something like that. So, there is a lot of time to save, and that's not time that's coming out of, you know, fairy luck at this point. So. Ooh. Pretty decent fight. Damn, I turn the light on really quick here. There we go. Cool. So yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Definitely something to keep in mind, but it's not like I have to make any decisions now. It's a little early to get on that hype train. Still got one other fairy to go. Although, I mean, I did have a run the other night where the fairy luck wasn't exactly magnificent. And I was on really good pace, so. Gotta make sure my execution is up to snuff. On top of good RNG. Did I click the picture of Miku that you posted? No. I'm a little busy, as it turns out. Unless you're asking someone else. But yeah, the only cutscenes in this game that you can actually take focus away from La-Mulana without it affecting anything are the introductory cutscene and the credits cutscene. But all of the stuff where, like, you know, the bosses are dying, you know, congratulations, you've obliterated Elmac or whatever. If the game loses focus, then it just stops. So I'll have to avoid that. You're paranoid until I get the door open. Ah. that track pattern. Keep skipping ahead for you. That sucks. Sorry to hear that, drag. Actually, that's another reason why I haven't streamed or done anything like that in the last few days. I mean, one, I was busy with, that's annoying. With my paper. You little pesky. But, yeah. My, what do you call it? A buddy of mine had been wanting to play some multiplayer games that, are quite large. So, I wound up downloading, like, what was it, Resident Evil 6 and Natural Selection 2 and some other stuff. It was like 70 or 80 gigs when it was all said or done. So my ISP was like, so that's too much. Not that they literally emailed me, but I do have a cap. And that cap is incredibly large, and I never go over it, so I don't really complain about it, but it happened. Although it is kind of nice, they don't cut off service completely, they just give you, you know, service that isn't the balls awesome stuff that you normally get. My ISP is very good, and I love them. They're so much better than all of the other local, huge companies. Oops, I'm not jumping that way. Yeah, I'm kind of inclined to agree that a lot of the bosses do get easier with the speedrunning strats when you're just kind of going for it crazy. However, I do think a part of that is going to go into what kind of items we have and when. So, YOLO strats for Elmac, pretty good if you've got the axe. If you don't have the axe, they're really bad. I do not pay overage fees. So, I just continue to get service. It's just not, you know, amazing service. Or amazing. Well, I mean, you know, it's still, like, the quote, service is fine. But, you know, the connection is less. I almost didn't get that money pod for some reason. Yeah, fighting V can be a bit of a pickle if you're not really going for it. Like a no damage V fight is I think that would be challenging, in all likelihood. And yes, I'm including the damage that you take from Caltrops from, you know, quote, no damage. Yeah. My SP also does give you the option if it's like, hey, add on, you know, a giant number of gigabytes for like $5. But I was just like, yeah, whatever. I'll just deal with it. Okay, I'm gonna do this because this guy is going to be inconvenient otherwise. Okay, he's going to be inconvenient anyways. Jerk. Yeah, no, and it'll be... Like, I basically get a redirect to the page when they're like, hey, you hit your cap. What do you want to do about it? Do you want to pay us for, you know, more bandwidth at your current speed? Or do you want to continue on with this kind of a thing? So, it's cool to get that option. Second try, that's cool. It's very cool. I like it. Don't even think about it. All right, big boy, what do you got? Come on. Reach out and touch someone. Yeah. I mean, like, the price per gigabyte isn't, you know, what they actually pay. It's like, you know, $5 for 25 gigs or something like that. When actual costs for that sort of thing are, like, cents. But it's by far a hell of a lot better than what their quote competitors would offer. Little bit of walking and one shot out of Saki kind of sucks, but it could be worse. I've seen him do much worse. No. Buttons. How do they work? Mm. cute. Keep whipping too fast on that first Vimana. And then engaging the invulnerability frames. See what we can get from the item fairy. Getting a lot of chakra drops. It's curious. Okay. Hey Cube, thanks. Cool. I even have one extra culture up here. I guess I did get a couple in drops off of a few things. So. Always nice. Can't rely on drops or caltrops. Wonder if this guy would give me a discount if he knew that I was going to buy in bulk. Ghosts? Fuck off. Seriously. It's where I need to go, the Costco of caltrops. Didn't think I got him with that. Range of the axe is deceptively long. Come here, you. God, more chakrams. What is going on? Ice Wizard got what he deserved. Let that be a lesson to all of the other Ice Wizards in this game. This is what happens. This is what happens when you wizard ice. I guess this guy didn't get the memo. But he will. Oh, he will. And by memo, I mean flail whip. It's just a matter of time. Yeah, you keep doing that, buddy. You keep doing that. Weird, Drek. I actually wouldn't really know the first thing about what to do about that. I don't know if that's an issue on my end. Oh, iOS works fine. Okay. But I've never actually viewed my stream on a mobile device. For multiple reasons. One, I don't typically use a mobile device for watching streams, and two, when I'm streaming, I'm not really watching myself. So, it's kind of a twofold problem. I'm not sure what to do about either of those. Oh dear. All these construction accidents. You know, if he was wearing a high visibility jacket, that wouldn't have happened. Right, backlog. Alright, somebody change the sign. And make sure you take off your helmet when you do that. You know, show a little respect to the dearly departed red jumpy rolly thingy guys. I have no idea what those are called. But, you know, we should show whatever those things are lots of respect, clearly. Thank you. Ooh. Went for the risky forehit, and it paid off. I missed one of my whips on the first cycle. He only takes 6, which is why I do 3 and 3. You can get in 4, but it's less consistent. And there's not really a purpose to doing it, because you can't one cycle Chiyo. So I just do the 3 and 3, but yeah. Worked out alright. That, however, was not that cool. Panthers, please stop. Yeah, imagine how fast the dimensional corridor would go. Like, Tiamat and all the other bosses are on strike. That would be awesome. Cool. Whoop. I say, I think that invisible fish was trying to kill me. That was supposed to look much cooler than it did, because I kept getting shot by those stupid skeletons. Oh well. Full credit to Ultra J-Man for inspiring that idea in me. It's something they do in the original. And I've never even thought of doing that, so I tested it out, and sure enough, it works. I'm calling it Sticky Wicked is the best euphemism of 2014. I don't think there's too much to worry about with these last couple of splits. In my PB and whatnot, these ones have been pretty good. I haven't really had a line on beating that, or getting close to beating that Amphis Bane split in quite a few runs. And there are plenty of time savings ahead. Bad Amphis Bane fight. Yeah, unfollowed, unliked, unsubscribed. Buttons. I'm pressing them too fast or something. Cool. That guy was behaving himself. Last thing I need is one of these Bonicons to shit all over my run. Drumline. Badump. Please furnish me with a healing fairy. Thank you. God damn it. Fucking ghost. That's frustrating. There's nothing I can do about that. That's gonna cost me. I will need to haul ass and get a good pattern on Baphomet. Of course. Bats? Seriously. No. God damn it. I could have used the knife there. I was thinking the axe wasn't going to be good enough, which I don't think it would have at that angle, but I could use the knife. My health is a little bit lower than it normally is at this point because I had to do... an extra trip on the third floor of the Endless Corridor. Because of the ghost. Wow, okay. Yeah, just pull out all the stops, why don't you? Seriously. I whipped. Whip is more than quick enough to kill that bomb mouse. So dumb. This split is so bad. I will be lucky to break even at this point, I think. An interesting thought. Wonder if you could grapple off of the wall there to jump to the lowest platform. Might be tight, but I think you have the angle for it. Let's speed that up a little bit. I'm even lower because I took some abuse in the True Shrine of the Mother. This is actually a somewhat dangerous dangerous health value. But I think I should make it through this section, okay? I don't understand how that happened, but whatever. I'm losing time. I might be losing a lot of time. Getting a two cycle there is the only thing that is really salvaging this segment at all, and it's still not going to be very good. Oh, that burns my ass. So much trolling. Why, La-Mulana? Why? Although, if I'm going to take that line of questioning, I might as well ask why a toaster toasts. Oh wow, I didn't even notice that. I knew I improved this. I got a gold segment on this, like a couple of runs ago? I didn't realize that I got it under 2 minutes. It's pretty good. Though being probably the shortest split in the entire run, there's not a lot that can go wrong here, and it is a fairly consistent segment for me. I would not expect to gain or lose a lot here. Second, though, I'll take it. I will take it. Damn. Why do I have this nagging suspicion that I skipped out of his dialogue in a way that I've never done before in any run? Oh, if Shorn isn't up here, I'm going to be very upset. Father is a smart man. Okay, good bat pattern there. The one on the right can sometimes give you a really annoying thing, which prevents you from getting to the diary on the first cycle of the elevator. So it was not. Hey, Dave Flair. I'm working on it. One full price pizza coming up. Interesting. I've never done that before. Jeez. These guys go shopping at Chakram City? Chakram City. It's like Spatula City, but with chakrams. Get that fake goddess statue out of here. Can't fool me. I used to be really bad at that for some reason. Not like really bad, actually. Just, you know, not good. I haven't screwed it up in a while now, so I guess that's nice. Chock full of chakrams. There we go. Cool. I didn't try to equip the Cog of the Soul before I'd picked it up yet. That's what we call using your noodle. I knew there was a reason I finished this game. It's because I'm smart. Or something. Maybe persistent would be a better word. I'm really glad that I'm terrified of forgetting that Ankh. Because if I wasn't terrified, I think I actually would forget. I'd just walk by it casually, because I'm not feeling this rampaging anxiety within me, yelling and screaming at the top of its lungs, "Dude, do not forget the Ankh in the secret shop, in the Chamber of Birth." The best kind of terrifying, gripping fear in a speedrun. Where are you going? Huh? Thank you, Buckler. In other news, a random key sword appeared today in La-Mulana, in the Chamber of Birth. Authorities are looking for the Keyblade, but believe it has fled the state. More information as this develops. Sorry, bumped the mic. Keyblade was just lonely. I understand. But we can't be together anymore. It's just not meant to be. But at least we'll always. Jerk. Oh, wow. Hit him in the back of the head with that last one. Dweeb. Doofus. Dork. Jerk. Moron. For those of you that might be confused, I am referencing a race out of Star Control 2, who regain energy by insulting their opponents. They were pretty awesome. But their ships were so hard to control. I mean, you know, having good maneuverability in a small fighter craft is good, but these things were ridiculous. God, I don't remember what they were called. My brain wants to say, like, Picat or something like that, but that's not right. Maybe something that sounds like it. They were pretty funny, though. The Pekunk. Yes, thank you, Scatterbrains. By the way, totally appropriate username for the content of what was going on in my head while not being able to remember it. That game had some freaking good music, dude. Really good music. I don't know about this one. Oh, I didn't get it. Damn it. That's unfortunate. The two screen transitions there are actually going to cost a little bit of time rather than if I had just waited for the elevator. Are you kidding me? I pressed left twice. I wish the teleporting menus in this game and the menus in general were just more responsive. Like, as fast as I am hitting the button, that is how quickly you are moving the cursor. And I mean, I guess it's sort of fine. Oh, you know, you get used to the rhythm of it or whatever. I'm just like, ah. Are you kidding me? Oh yeah, if number keys warped me instantly, absolutely. I'd just have to remember which one's which. Damn it. Alright, well it was three, but it was a quick three, so... You didn't spend a lot of time in the air. Yeah, true enough, SEL, but... Yeah, I'm just... I want things to happen when I press buttons. Not to... press buttons and stand there looking like an idiot. Like I am now. Please, worm fight, go better than this. Why did I not hit that first one? I was like literally... The whip was inside its hitbox. I don't understand. Whatever. Can always take a little bit at a time, or a little bit of time out of the speedrun, to smell the roses. Or in this case, kill bats. Another flare, I think, would have done it for that phase. Bad laser pattern. This fight should be over. You've got to be kidding me! I'm so angry. I'm so angry at the teleporting right now. That Tiamat fight did not go well either. Not even going to bother getting this pot, because I don't have enough money for the extra flares. By 20 gold, so getting that 10 right there is not really going to do anything for me. So I'm not going to bother. I'll just make do with, yeah, 11's fine. Just to make it official, if it wasn't already apparent, I am tuning out here, guys, so I'll see you on the other side. Thank you. Boy, am I glad there's not an eye in that room. Sup, Letts. Thank you. Jeez. Oh, man. Yeah, sorry, all. No free pizza for you tonight. Damn. Oh, if I had... What is it? The, oh, that ghost in the endless corridor, man. And numerous other bats and flying things that were annoying. I guess so, Dave Flair. I was trying to concentrate because I was like, I know I can do a better mother and mantra split. But yeah, a 0.1, a tenth of a second wasn't exactly what I had in mind when I'm like, I'm gonna buckle down and I'm really gonna fire this one out. You know, this is, I wasn't thinking a tenth of a second. I was thinking, you know, few seconds, something, anything. Bad. Yeah, thanks everybody. Yeah, maybe you should, SCL. Maybe you should. Damn. Well, that's definitely a run. I still want to hit that, pardon me. I still want to hit that sub 145. I'm not far out. Not far out at all. But, I think I'm more incentivized because there's a few things in that run that I'm just flatly unhappy with. But hey, you know, I've got plenty more no reset practice to do prior to SGDQ. Hoi. So yeah, I'm sure I'll get more cracks at it between here and then. And if not, maybe I will just wind up seeing if I can grind out attempts and see if I can get something that's sub 145. But, pretty nice. 14 second PBs, nothing to sneeze on. I'm halfway to my goal. Between where I was and where I want to go.